Heliotour mission. Please feel free to download the integral text in PDF format by clicking here. Managed by Glycan Industries Corp. LTD UK. Glycan Space XR, Heliotour LLC USA. Glycan Industries LLC USA. Glycan Space XR LTD UK. Glycan Holding AG, X Neutral Metal SA, Switzerland. Lenticular airships, helium, Earth. Extraterrestrial options, other gases on planets or moons. Size of the airship, 60 meters to 100 meters diameter, with a payload, 15 to 75 tons, which is directly proportional to the airship's volume at ground level, less the general structure, including propulsion and equipments. 1 cubic meter of helium can lift 1 kilogram. Therefore, an airship of 100,000 cubic meters of helium could transport 100 tons. However, taking into account the 25 tons of the airship's own weight, the actual payload would be 75 tons. Heliotour will provide the following services to industries. Transportation. Heavy structures, dismantling of factories, parts of bridges, oil rigs, chimneys, etc., and equipments, engines, turbines, generators, filters, etc. Trucks, door-to-door. Large quantities of drinkable water. Hazardous wastes and chemicals that cannot be transported safely by road, rail, or sea. Surveillance and monitoring. National hydrology map. Hydroelectric plants. Geophysical assessments. Forest and brush fire surveillance and subsequent firefight with hybrid Heliotour, helium and air. Telecommunications. Rescue missions over land and sea. Capabilities of the lenticular Heliotour. The lenticular shape of Heliotour has been demonstrated to be the best shape. Aerodynamic studies of an 8 meters diameter model in speed wind tunnel testing, Wanneroo, France, to move in air, including in atmospheric perturbation zones with wind of 120 km an hour, without any structural damage, even in the case of oscillator mode. The payload capability is assumed by helium gas, HE, which is a non-inflammable monoatomic gas, weight of 4 compared to the average atmospheric molecular weight of 78.084% nitrogen, 20.947% oxygen, 28.84.1 cubic meter of helium can lift approximately 1 kilogram under standard conditions, temperature and room pressure, 15 degrees Celsius, 288.15 degrees Kelvin, 1013 millibars. A mole of gas occupies a volume of 22.4 liters at 1 atmospheric pressure and 273.15 degrees Kelvin. Helium density is 0.0001785 grams per centimeters squared. Helium is considered a noble gas since it is difficult to associate the helium atom, 1s2, to another atomic element. This means that it is completely inert and therefore non-flammable. On Earth, the air composition is as follows. The airship's movements and capabilities respond to the general laws of physics, dynamics, and thermodynamics, whereby air is considered as a deformable fluid and the airship as a solid subjected to the Earth's gravity within the context of the medium. Thus, the general equations of hydrodynamics can be applied to the airship's mathematical model, specialized matrices. Consequently, the capabilities of the airship depend on the medium's quality and its perturbation by the solid dynamic state of the airship. The distribution of the field forces varies with regard to the partial anisotropy state, when in movement, and to the partial isotropy state, when the airship is grounded, without oscillator mode. Within a context of environmental stress, the lenticular shape of the airship attains greatest stability in comparison to other shapes tested. Heliotour will be constructed with advanced composite materials, including some parts of the engine, in boron nitride, BN3, and specialized polymers, because the only defect of helium is its relative diffusion in materials, such as the helium holding tank, and because of temperature differences inside and outside of the Heliotour, the diffusion could be accelerated if classic membranes are used. Therefore, the helium pressure needs to remain constant or diminished by a calculated percentage. The required pressure can be attained with additional liquid helium stocked in the heliotor or at the airship's reception base. The propulsion of the heliotor is obtained by hybrid mode, electric supply power, silicon cells, and fuel cells. One small top region of the heliotor will be equipped with silicon cells providing electric current for general flight control, monitoring, and radio transmissions. The fuel cells will provide energy for electric propulsion and emergency situations. The propulsion engine will be low velocity turbines, with 3D freedom, to move the heliotor correctly. The propulsion will be coupled with a predictor program monitored by the onboard pilots. Within a predictive context, the flight can be automatically undertaken, with the exception of arrival and startup operations. Heliotor airships will be constructed within a customized context, responding to a given client's specific needs, including required payload, volume, lenticular criteria, mass structure, coupling equipment, payload and airship, propulsion, hybrid or helium only, equipments, monitoring, protection, autonomy, velocity, pilots and mechanics, and insurances. General observations. The Heliotor airship can fly at several altitudes, 300 meters to 2,000 meters, and transport easily 15 to 75 tons, at an average velocity of 120 kilometers per hour. The volume of the airship can be between 30,000 cubic meters and 100,000 cubic meters. With appropriate power supply, direct silicon quantum converter and fuel cells, the airship has several days of autonomy. Model MQ-1 Pegasa 8 meters diameter 1 or 1975, wind tunnel test successful, Christian Daniela sound on the left side. Never again. Proposal for the Heliotor mission. Fire prevention and fight. California, France, Portugal, Canada. Application in California, reduced Heliotor engine 32 meters in diameter. Note. This project is aimed at decision makers and governmental players involved in managing the causes and consequences of forest fires and pine forest fires disasters, triggered in a criminal, accidental, or natural way in California. Problems. Direct, indirect, and collateral damages. At least $7 billion each year, in the USA, are spent, lost, in various repairs, payment of subcontractors or replacement of interventional materials and additional investments to fight and prevent on-site. Ecological consequences are difficult to evaluate while the moral and psychological damage on victims is not quantified in this brief presentation. Recurrent fires, regardless of their origins, are deeply prejudicial to the ecobiosystems and to societal and economic development. The authorities mobilizing professionals or volunteers competent in the field of civil security cannot apply preventive methods because the losses are detected or prevented too late, despite the will of both. The suffering of property and persons is not acceptable and is deeply unfair. The financial efforts of the insurance companies are subjected to a severe ordeal which we consider unfair and vexatious, as well as aid from the states, which is subject to eventual punishment that could be avoided. Solutions. Preventive measures and missions. Glycan Space XR Heliotor LLC and Glycan Industries Corp. Limited offer to the actors in these disasters an atmospheric heliostatic engine, neutral gas filled with helium, of lenticular shape and 30 meters in diameter and able to be positioned geostationary at 21 kilometers but also able to carry out surveillance and prevention or intervention missions at 1 kilometers altitude in sensitive areas in California. Heliotor could participate in other missions including hydrological, meteorological, and rescue monitoring in areas that may be flooded or inaccessible to helicopters, natural disasters, transport of sensitive equipment, radio communications, surveillance of the territory, wild deforestation, among others. Depending on the needs, Heliotor would be equipped with an electric propulsion, external motors, via fuel cells and solar rescue, embedded equipment, high technology of detection of the radiation in the visible and invisible domains, spectrometry, and of high-resolution cameras, means of transmission of the data. This equipment has already existed for a long time on combat aircraft and helicopters, but also classically in the large space agencies on military satellites. Various organizations could be interested worldwide. High-resolution cameras in the event of incident detection could also extend their scanning to 300 or 500 meters around the target point and photograph possible vehicles involved in criminal acts. Onboard equipment could reach 300 kilograms and the piloting could be robotized, as well as the installation of the sequences of intervention device by device and analysis of the alert and countermeasures. Following the execution of the analysis specification, depending on the distance between Heliotor and the geodesy of the target and the qualification of the alert, the coordinates of the incident would be sent to the competent authorities, either for immediate intervention or be entrusted for various reasons to Heliotor, control and command station. Heliotor could detect a spectral image, a fire start of 30 centimeters in diameter, or a smoke of particles rising between 10 meters and 50 meters, by embedded absorption spectrometry or laser diffractometry. Heliotor could also house a programmed retro-parachute drone in the cargo bay that could dump beacons in the center of the aggressive zone and issue the exact geodesy to be targeted to the authorities. This methodology could be applied in general by civil protection in the context of refineries or reserves of drinkable water, active or inactive nuclear power stations, and finally any infrastructure deserving intelligent surveillance, intercommunication. Heliotor should be a powerful preventive tool adaptable to various missions, including the transport of indivisible masses, nuclear or petrochemical plants to be dismantled and therefore indivisible payload. The dimensions of Heliotor should be revised upwards, either from 30 meters to 100 meters. In case of necessary security measures, Heliotor aircraft navigating at low altitude could embark countermeasures equipment with the possible use of thermal decoy signatures, in order to avoid possible attempts by terrorists to send terror to air rockets. Sol-air missiles cannot reach the geostationary Heliotor at 21 km altitude. Heliotor could not be destroyed by conventional weapons of war because it is not filled with flammable gas, but helium is inert, and Heliotor could be composed of honeycomb cells in Kevlar, and some damaged cells could not. The technical viability of Heliotor. A permanent beacon in agreement with the civil or military authorities would be installed on Heliotor. The return to the ground of Heliotor for reasons of maintenance or incident would not pose any danger for inhabited or industrial areas. The management of industrial pollutions should be part of Heliotor's specifications. The customs services should be interested in Heliotor as well as the port authorities, and therefore for the defense of the territory. Frequent questions, FAQ, and logical responses. Question: how is it that it doesn't yet exist in the tools of the authorities? Answer: the novelty, even old, is scary and nobody wants to take responsibility. It is the good old method of the umbrella. About novelty, all the technologies embedded on Heliotor have existed since the Cold War between the USA and Russia. It is not a matter of putting in place complex and time-consuming research and development to deal with these problems of fire prevention, nor of qualifying a new particle in nuclear physics, but simply of bringing together skills and feed rate the real wills in the United States and California. Question: how much does a Heliotor cost? Answer: it is comparable to a military truck, parts and labor and especially embedded options. We estimate that a budget of $3 million should be suitable, excluding purchase of a construction zone. Heliotor would be in the envelope total budget for approximately $7 million. Financial losses of $7 billion cannot be considered as turnover. The sum of $7 million compared to the loss of $7,000 million, $7 billion, is ridiculous. It is 1,000th and it raises questions. Question: why didn't you propose it before? Answer: there are experts in this field who will be urging us as promoters of the Heliotor project to move forward as soon as possible in the construction of these engines in France. The merit of the prioritization in the aerostats belonging to the French, Montgolfier Brothers, in order to be ready for summer 2018, if possible. Our field of expertise is mainly focused on space research, extraterrestrial mining, including Moon, Mars, asteroids, and also on the cleaning of the satellite space encumbered by inactive, commercial or military, satellites in NEO, LEO, geo-Earth orbit, and which represent a significant hazard. Patents Plasma Tools 2006 PCT 2016 filed in the United States Patent and Trademark Office and entered the PCT phase, international. Note, a joint venture between Glycan Industries LLC and Goodyear at Tucson could be an interesting way. Anteriority in competence. Christian Daniel Asaun AT3. In charge of the manufacturing of the Pegase 1975 2-meter diameter model CNRSING Varieurs LE Buisson 91, France, the model of 8 meters of diameter, MQ1, was tested favorably in Wanneroo-Mouton wind tunnel for its form of lenticular shape, France. Project Director Pierre Balaskovic 1973 CNRSING Varieurs LE Buisson 91, France. Author of the project proposal Heliotour September 16, 2017. Dr. Christian Daniel Asaun, Ph.D. in Atomic Spectroscopy Paris 7 1979 Mouton CNRSING Samuel Weniger, Director of Research. Former NASA JPL Advisor 1981-1982 Pasadena CA. Author of PERG Project Plasma for Extraterrestrial Resources and Applied Technologies addressed to NASA JPL 1981. 2016 present, President Glycan SpaceX R, Heliotour LLC USA Pasadena 91101. 2008, present Director Glycan SpaceX R Corp. LTD UK. Note. Spin-offs of Heliotour. Planet Benefit, Earth. Planet Benefit, Earth, Reconstruction of the Ozone Layer, O3, Earth. Planet Benefit, Earth, Transportation and Settlement on Moon and Mars, others. Contact us, Allied Industries Headquarters at glycangroup.com.